Coming up, we'll show you Cloud Shell, a new way for managing resources in the cloud. We'll show you how within the browser you can use Bash or PowerShell to troubleshoot and automate your most common management tasks, and manage on the go by keeping your favorite scripts in the cloud so that you can trigger them with Cloud Shell from any modern browser or the Azure mobile app. I'm joined by Corey Sanders from the Azure Compute team, a regular here on Microsoft Mechanics. Welcome back, man.
You know, Rick, it's really, really good to be here with you.
Most folks know and are familiar with the Azure portal. Mm-hmm. It works for most management tasks that you're going to be going through with common scenarios. But in the past, whenever you've been on the show, you've always been demoing from the command line.
That's right.
If you wanted to have this level of flexibility, you'd have to go in and configure your workstation, load all the tools, load all the dependencies. But Cloud Shell improves the thing significantly. Can you explain to me what it is and how it all works?
Yeah, absolutely, Rick. I can try to explain it to you, and let's see whether you can follow. And so what we've done here with the Cloud Shell is it truly is a browser-based experience for running in the cloud. And so you can use Bash, you can use PowerShell, and right here in the portal experience, you can go manage, you can deploy, you can troubleshoot all kinds of problems you may have without ever leaving the portal experience.
Okay.
And so the benefit of this, the benefit of the Cloud Shell is it truly is a shell in the cloud, hence the name. And so if I go up here and you see this button up here, it says Cloud Shell. And so right here in the experience, I can click this up and I've got a prompt ready for me to execute whatever command I may want. And so here you can see I can click in here and say list, and it'll show me all the things running. It'll show me a set of tools that I may want to run. It actually already connected a cloud drive that is an Azure file location that I have set up for this and uploaded a bunch of tools. And so now right here in this file shell, using the portal to upload, I can now execute a bunch of commands right here in the Bash prompt.
Now, so for all the folks that are watching, how does actually all this work?
So in Azure, there are literally thousands of containers configured with environments waiting for you to just connect. Mm-hmm. They're just sitting there waiting, saying, Rick, please connect with me. Do some fun things in the shell. They are geo-diversified, so you end up getting deployed to whatever the closest container is to you. And so that will be the one that's made available and launched. And when you hit request, it launches them up, it connects to it, and then it will attach your Azure file storage so you can put whatever tools and whatever capabilities that you wanted available. Now, what's nice is that it is just a browser experience. And so it runs, of course, on your laptop, but it will also run on a phone or a tablet, any browser that you want.
Now, do you have to be in the Azure portal to use the Cloud Shell?
No, actually, this is one of the best parts about it. So certainly it's available right here in the Azure portal, but you can also, if you're in the documentation page, let's say, mm-hmm. and you're scanning through it and you're saying, look, I want to create a virtual machine on Linux and I want to use the Azure CLI, and you're walking through it and you're trying to learn how this works, and you're like, okay, there's a command here, and you see this little button, try it. So I hit this in the documentation page and it creates an Azure Cloud Shell right here in the documentation page. And it's so cool. Now I can go in and say, okay, great. Now I'm going to go try this out. This is my account. It's pre-created. And I can go in and I can actually go run a command right here in the documentation page. And so it's available for me. All the tools are ready. I'm authenticated. I'm ready to go.
So the magic of all this is that you completely have this extracted from you. It's always up to date. And your stuff is inside the cloud and following you around.
Absolutely. So you can go do this, any sort of operation you want to go run, you can go ahead and use the Cloud Shell for it.
So why don't you actually show me some of what you can do inside the Cloud Shell?
Well, I will. Absolutely, okay. Rick. Yeah. So I you're antsy about this. Let me actually go and show you something. So in this case, let's assume I have a virtual machine that's gone bad. Okay. And so I've got a virtual machine that's gone bad, and I've written a script that is going to allow me to troubleshoot this bad machine, mm-hmm. okay? And so I've got all my tools here, I'm ready to go, and so to give you a little example of sort of what this looks like, I can right here in the portal experience, take a look at what this script's gonna do. And so let me actually maximize this. I'm gonna spend my time in the shell, and so I'm gonna make it bigger. So here, right here in, with Vim, right here in Bash, I can now see the script. I can see what it's gonna do, I can see what it's gonna attach to, and very, very easy for me to go edit it if I want to. In this case, I'm actually okay with it, and so let me actually get out of here. Okay, and now I wanna run it, right? And so I'm gonna attach this, it's gonna create a VM for me that is going to run this and attach this broken VM to this new VM that I'm creating, okay? So I'm gonna run in the background and away that goes, okay? And so As part of that, let me now assume that that is going and running. And instead, what I want to do is I actually want to go look at that VM that's now attached, that broken VM, to it. Okay? And so to do that, I can actually call out a command here. And now that we've run the script to attach the broken VM to a new healthy VM, now all I need to do is connect to it.
Okay.
So I got to find it first. And so let me go in and actually through this same experience, I'm actually going to list out the IP addresses so that I can find out what the IP address that I need to connect to. So here you can see I've got the clean VM here up and running, okay? And what I'll end up doing actually is I'm gonna SSH. And what's great about this is that because I created it right here in the shell and it's got the cloud drive behind it, all of my credentials are here. Okay. So I don't need to do any credentials. I don't need to do anything special. I just hit SSH and I get the IP address here. Copy that, paste it there. And then just like that, I'm now connected.
Logged in. Right?
And so from here, I've now mounted this. So let me actually go to the mount point for this. See here, remounted OS disk. And you can see here now I've got this broken VM ready for me to go debug a little bit further, understand what happened, all of that happening via scripts, VM creation in a fully automated way right here in the Bash experience right here in the portal.
Now, this looks great on a browser, but what if I don't have access to my laptop or to a browser even? What's the experience like on a phone?
Yeah, Rick, you know, as I explained before, and maybe you missed it when I explained it, you can also run this on a phone in addition to laptop and tablet. So here I'm logged into the Azure Portal experience on the phone. You can see all the VMs that I've already showed, the clean VM and so on that I connected to. And so right here, I can go in and actually say Cloud Shell. And so here you can see I've actually got the Cloud Shell here up and running. And so I can do all sorts of things. I can go ahead and list things. I can go in just like I did on there. I can hit list, right? I can actually do Vim editing if I really want to right here in this experience. And so you see, just absolutely powerful to be able to go in here just using this same thing. And so actually, let me go into my cloud drive. And so maybe I wanted to actually run the exact same command that I just ran. And so maybe I can do Vim here and do trouble disk. .sh. And so here I can go in, and of course it brings up Vim just like it does on that experience. It's absolutely fantastic.
Now, you've shown us this experience using Bash, but I know a lot of people that watch mechanics are interested in PowerShell.
Of course.
So what does Cloud Shell do for them?
Yeah, so the PowerShell support is in private preview, okay. But it's almost an identical experience, right? And so if you go into that portal experience and you click up here and you do, again, similar sort of Cloud Shell command, it pulls up just like the Bash experience, only of course, PowerShell Blue,
right?
And so here we are in the PowerShell experience, right? And so I can go here and do some, you know, just the normal commands that you'd expect, hit dir, right? And be able to take a look and investigate what I want to run with PowerShell. But now what's super cool about PowerShell, that's actually quite powerful, it is not just a PowerShell experience. It's actually a namespace mapping to your full account.
Okay.
Yeah, so what I can do here, you can see I hit dir, and it actually shows me all of my subscriptions. So I can go into these subscriptions. I can say Core application, right? And maybe I want to do CD, and I'm just walking this like it's a file system, but it's actually my Azure account. It's absolutely fantastic. And so here you can see now I've got all of my resource groups in here. And so let me just see here, test VM. Let me go into that and then see what it's got. So let me go into compute here. Mm-hmm. And so here you can see, I can just walk this tree, and now I can see what's in here, and it looks like there's virtual machines deployed here in test VM. And so if I pull this up, now you can see it's a Windows server, it's running server 2012 R2 data center, and it's called working VM, okay? And so right here in PowerShell, in this experience now, I've got this fantastic ability to walk the namespace. But that's not all, Rick. I can also go in and actually run just your standard PowerShell commands.
Okay.
Right? And so right here, I can go in if I want to stop a VM, let's say. So let's see, Azure RM VM. Let's hit name, working VM, resource group name, test VM. And that all looks right. Always got to double check that I type things right. And right there, of course, validate to make sure that's what I want to do.
Right.
Okay. And away I go. VM stopped, ready to go.
Now, what about if you want to run commandlets that aren't part of your default experience?
Yeah, absolutely. So just like I would do with PowerShell running, let's say on my local box, just like PowerShell running anywhere else, I can go in and I can actually customize and install modules as I see fit. So if I were deploying here, and let's say I said, hey, you know, I want to do something with Azure Active Directory, right? So now I may need to go in and actually customize that. So to find the module, you can run just the standard commands. So find module, say Azure AD, okay? And so this is now searching to determine, you know, about this module. How do I install it? How do I go configure it? And so it's searching for the Azure AD module. And there, I see it's found it. So now actually what I want to go do is I want to go install this module. So now, just like you'd expect, I can pipe this right in into install module. And so it will find it, and then it will install it and run that. And of course, because this is running on Cloud Drive, it will install it in such a way that I can then use it from now on, right? So I can, anytime I come back, this will be installed because it will basically save aside all of that state for me. And so here you go, it's downloading, it's unzipping, and this should be ready here in just a moment.
Awesome stuff. This is gonna make it way easier to go ahead and manage your resources in Azure. And as you show, you can literally do this from anywhere. How can you get started with Cloud Shell today?
Well, as I showed earlier in my demo, and maybe you missed it or were busy, you can go right into the portal experience, you can hit the little button in the upper right, and you've got the Cloud Shell, and you're ready to use it straight away today. It's amazing. You should go try it out for yourself. And of course, give us feedback as you try it.
Thanks again, Corey, for joining us again. And for everyone else watching, stay tuned to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest in updates. See you soon.